Hi, my name is Bintu and today I am going to teach you how to insert a node in a singly linked list. I assume that you have seen my earlier videos where I have taught you how to create a singly linked list, how to display it, how to delete a node. Here in this code, I will be only focusing on how to insert a node. Please visit these links to see my earlier videos. Because it's a singly linked list, I am defining a structure node which has two members. I am assuming that I am creating a single linked list which comprises only of a single integer. I can have even strings, I can have float or any kind of data member. But to make it simple, I am taking an integer linked list. I am defining a structure which has an integer data member called data and a pointer called next which will point to the structure of type node. It is a self-referential structure. It will point to the structure of its own type only. I am also assuming there is a pointer start list which is a global pointer which points to the singly linked list which is created. Here there are four prototypes. They are very explanatory. Like one is for creating linked list. This will display the linked list content. This will delete the linked list content. Here this is a method which I am going to explain to you that inserts a new node. When you run this program you get a menu which will show you five options. You press 1 to create a linked list, press 2 to show its content, 3 for delete, 4 is for inserting a node which we are going to understand. These are the functions that will be called when a user enters an integer value. And the program will terminate when the user presses 5. 5 is for quitting from the menu. This is the code for inserting linked list. Let's assume that this is a single linked list which is already created and it has 4 nodes. The first node is being pointed by start list which is a global pointer. While inserting a node, there are 3 circumstances. Like user might want to insert before the first node, user might want to insert in between any node, or the user might want to insert before the last node. We understand all the 3 circumstances. Let's begin with the code. Here, it's allocating the memory for the new node. This is the size of the structure node. This much number of bytes are allocated, and that memory which is being allocated is typecasted to be used by the structure called node. And that allocated memory is assigned to new node. That is, a new node is created by name new node. You are asking the user to enter a value that has to be inserted. Suppose the user inserts 7. That will be assigned to the data member of the new node. The next pointer, next member of the new node is set to null initially. You are asking the user where you want to insert the new node. Suppose user inserts 5. Assuming that user wants to insert before the first node. That 5 is assigned to the integer value location. You are first checking if the start list is null, that is if the linked list does not exist. In that case, you are asking the start list pointer to point at the new node and you are declaring that the node is inserted. Because the single linked list does not exist, so obviously the first node, the new node will be the first node of the linked list and it will exit. But if the linked list already exists and start list is pointing to the first node of that linked list, it will come over here. You are checking if the user wants to insert before the first node. If it will, the data member of start list will match with the location, that is with the 5. In that case, what you are doing? You are asking the next pointer of new node to point at start list. You are asking the next member of the new node to point at start list. And thereafter, the start list is set to point at the new node. The start list pointer is set to point at the new node. Why? Because you traverse the linked list beginning from the start list pointer. So when the start list will point here at the new node, while traversing the linked list, even this new node will be included in the traversal. So this new node is inserted before the first node. You get the message and the program will terminate. What if the user want to insert a new node in between the linked list? In that case, you will take the use of two pointers, temp1 and temp2. Temp1 will follow temp2. So temp1 is set to point at the start list here. And temp2 is set to point at the next member of the start list, that is here. And you will execute a loop to find where the user want to insert before which node. You are checking if the data member is equal to the location. Suppose the user inserts 8. That is, we want to insert a new node before 8. The 8 is assigned to location. You are checking if the data member of temp2 node is equal to 8. Is it? No. So both will move further. I mean temp1 will come at temp2 and temp2 will move at its next node. See, temp1 is set to point at temp2. So temp1 will move here. And temp2 is set to point at its next node, that is where its next member is pointing. So temp2 will come over here. Loop will execute. Let me tell you, this loop will terminate. The temp2 will reach the null pointer if the user inserts the value which does not exist in the linked list. In that case, it will come out saying that the location to insert is not found. It won't insert anything. This while loop will just check if the value where the user wants to insert exists or not. In any case, does the data member of temp2 equal to the location? Yes. We want to insert before this 8. In that case, what you will do? You will ask the next member of temp1 to point at the new node and the next member of new node to point at temp2. See, you will ask the next member of temp1 to point at new node and you will ask the next member of new node to point at temp2. This is how the new node is inserted. What if the user wants to insert before the last node? The code is still same. Temp1 and temp2 will move further with temp1 following temp2. They will keep on moving. Suppose the user wants to insert a new node before 3. So they will keep on moving. When the temp2 reaches the node before you want to insert a new node, what will happen? The code is still same. The next member of temp1 is set to point at new node and the next member of new node is set to point at temp2. That's inserted. Let's run the code. I am using Unix to run my code and for that I am using Kigwin software. Kigwin software provides you an environment on Windows to run Unix commands, Unix programs also. Here, this is the code that I've already written. Compile it. I'm using GCC compiler to compile the C programs. No error, no messages. That means the code is successfully compiled. Let's run this. You got a menu. Let's use the first option. Let's create the linked list. Enter integer value. Yes. 2. Yes. 3. Yes. 4. Want to add more? No. Let's display it. Press 2. This is the linked list which is created with the 4 elements. We want to insert. Say, let's press 4. Enter integer value that you want to insert. Let's enter 10. Where you want to insert, let's insert before the first node. 1. The node is inserted. You got the message, the node is inserted. Let's display it. 2. See, 10 is inserted. Let's insert again. 4. Enter integer value that you want to insert, 20. Where you want to insert, let's insert it before 3. The node is inserted, let's display it. See, 20 is inserted before 3. Let's again insert it before the last node. Say, press 4. I want to insert 30 before 4. It's inserted, let's display it. See, quit the program by pressing 5. So, the code is working properly. If you face any problem in understanding this code, you mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. For more of my videos, please visit my channel Bintu Harwani. Search for Bintu Harwani on youtube.com. Don't forget to subscribe me and please do write comments. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.